Forget what you learned in school. Never mind what your parents told you, and disregard what your friends say. From now on, the only people you need to listen to are these guys. For the next several minutes, they'll take you on a journey through the political jungle. And when your journey is over, you're safe at home. They promise you will be stronger, smarter, and well, just plain better. So when you go out into the world, men will pat you on the back and show you the door. So buckle up, hang on to your ears, because your journey starts now.
About living up in Canada is when it gets cold, we can have a reindeer in a shed and a moose in a bed.
Ooh, that's so true. And this is our Christmas show.
It is. Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays and all that rot.
Ooh, happy Hanukkah.
Happy Hanukkah.
Kwanzaa? When's Kwanzaa?
Oh, there's kinds of holidays this time of year.
Did we miss Kwanzaa?
I don't know if we missed. Hanukkah was like a few days ago, I think. So
I feel bad because
you do,
usually,
really.
Well, usually every year around this time, I give the history of Kwanzaa.
Yes, you do.
And I didn't prepare for it, and I don't want to wing it because I'll get it wrong.
No, it started like 4 years ago.
Someone will call me racist.
A national tradition 4 years
and
ago.
I don't want to do that.
God. All right. Well, anyways, it's December 22nd, right? You know, we're in the Freedom Studios on the 15th floor of the Patriot Towers. We're in Liberty City. Where at, Nate?
Our home base in Lansing.
We are in Lansing, Michigan, because we're all home with
United
our families.
States of America. Our families aren't home, but we're home.
No, well.
They left us.
they went to Florida, where it's nice and warm.
We were left home, wondering where they were.
They could
nothing to do but feed the pigs.
Swim in the surf naked. We can swim in the snow naked, but the police frown on that.
I got pulled over the other day.
Did you really?
Yep.
Go ahead. Tell me about it, because I will tell you about my trip over.
I got pulled over.
Yep.
The officer walked up to the window and said, hey.
Yeah.
And I said, hey.
Hey, how you doing?
I have guns. And he said, oh, where are they? And I told him. Uh-huh. And then he said, you have a headlight out. And I said, oh.
Thanks for letting me know.
Yep. And then, you know, because he said, I just like to tell people. And I said, yeah, that's cool. Fine. Pulled me over to tell me I have a headlight out. To me, if his intention was to just inform me,
right,
for safety's sake, the stop would have been over there.
Right. But he would have said, but everything.
License, registration, proof of insurance.
Because you might be an outlaw.
I'll be back in 5 minutes to see if you're a felon. And then
you're an outlaw.
I was like, it was in my town, and I said, you know who I am, right? And he said, yeah, that's why I pulled you over.
Yeah, okay, right, so. Right. You know the chief.
Yeah.
The police chief.
I didn't pull that one. Yeah. I guess I could have.
Yeah.
So how's the,
that's great,
how's
about
the chief's knee doing? Because, I could call him up if you want.
His little girl got into, you know, the basketball team, and
It was great.
We live in little towns in middle America. It's wonderful. Right? I mean, that's partly.
Yeah, it's not the middle at all.
That's great.
But that's fine.
No, we're in the Midwest, right?
Yeah, that's okay.
Where we are.
What does Midwest mean?
It means right in the Midwest.
We're in the, like, eastern third of the country.
Shut up. We're in the Midwest.
Okay.
And I just wanted to say it was delightful because I rode over to the studio, and it was dark, as it is this time of year.
You got here at 4 p.m., but it was dark.
But what's great is we're a day past the winter solstice, right? So the days are going to start getting longer and longer.
Yeah.
And have more light.
But great.
It was dark. And what was great is I could drive here, and I saw all the wonderful Christmas lights that were out, and all the Santa Clauses out in the streets, and I just had this warm, fuzzy feeling of Americana, that this country is just great and wonderful, and I haven't seen any more Christmas decorations. I mean, my little town that I live in is really, for some reason this year, maybe it's because Trump won, really have a lot of decorations out. the downtown businesses have a lot more lights out. The township has put out lights on their property, and it's just
wow.
It's just I got a warm fuzzy.
Wow, and there aren't any local families that don't celebrate Christmas that
we don't
to cause an issue.
We don't care about them. We just care about the 60% of Christian families.
I just know a little story about that town and a family that has had an issue in the past.
You mean with their school and having a Christmas holiday and they changed it to winter holiday?
Whatever it was. Did you see? This is made big news, by the way, in Lancaster, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think they were Amish, but there's a lot of Amish people in Lancaster.
Sure.
They were Jewish, so probably not Amish. But
I'm good point. I'm thinking the Jews were not Amish.
Yeah. So, So there's a school that has had a Christmas
pageant
or some sort every
some kind of celebration
every year, and the law changed, and so now they can't spend school hours working on it or something. I guess I'm not really sure.
That's ridiculous.
And a Jewish family requested that their child not be included in it, which is perfectly fine. I have no problem with that. Apparently, it was reported, supposedly, even though this isn't entirely accurate, but that family is the reason it was canceled.
Oh, they canceled
it? So they were so upset, and here's the cool
part.
Who's
they?
The Jewish family.
Okay.
Yeah, they canceled the show because they couldn't spend enough time. Based on the new law, they couldn't spend enough new time during the school day
to put on the show. Okay.
But people were apparently blaming this Jewish family because Donald Trump is what the article I read said. Since Donald Trump's election, there's been racism.
Right. Da-da-da, 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 Donald Trump.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Well, maybe...
They were so scared that they had to leave the county.
Are you kidding?
Which, I mean, it wasn't very far because Lancaster's not too far from the county.
Right, you just go a couple miles. And
really, it is. You cross the river, and I'm serious, and you're in another county. It's right. It's not that far. So now, if they were Amish by buggy, it's a day trip.
It's a good day trip. Depending on your horses. You know, if you had good horses, it could be a little faster. But so,
do you think we have any Amish listeners?
No, we don't. We shouldn't have any. They could hear it secondhand, perhaps, right? So I'm a Mennonite, and I listen to it. And, Joel at Odd Show really funny. They were making fun of the Amish. Oh, really? Well, we're going to take care of them, right? Hey,
They're Youpers?
Yeah, I don't know what they're going to do. No, they sound like that. Youpers sound like the Amish, so it's the same accent.
Oh, so anyway, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Happy holidays and all that rot.
You do have to be careful, though, because according to the AP,
I love this time
a new study says that the holidays, Christmas and New Year's holidays, there's a huge spike in accidental gun deaths during the holidays.
Oh, no.
So big that in the last 2 years.
Yes.
And you're going to want to sit down. This is
I'm sitting down.
In the last 2 years. There have been 32 people killed by accidental gunshots.
15 people a year.
Between 16, if you want to be good at math.
math is hard.
Between Christmas and New Year's.
And that's
nationwide.
And that's how many people nationwide?
330 million or something?
No, it's more than that. We're like 360, 70 million.
Well, if you count the illegals and the Amish.
And I do. So it's
are you kidding me?
It's like a 0.0000000%.
Now look, one accidental gun death is too many. Completely agree with that. It would be great if we could eliminate them. But this article,
I wonder.
It's an AP article. Hey. USA Today had it. Everybody's running. I saw our local news running it, making a huge deal out of this.
Okay, how many people are killed just having a Christmas tree in their house?
Oh, certainly not 32, Brian, in 2 years.
I would think it would be more.
Because, I think it is.
Because the Christmas tree falls over, kills you. Christmas tree catches fire.
That's a big tree.
Burns the whole house down. Thousands die.
Yeah. Well, I don't know about thousands.
Right.
So I don't know about that. But
Christmas tree becomes sentient and alive and hops through the house and starts eating children.
If you have one of those rotating Christmas tree bases,
yep.
You get caught up in there, spun to death.
It's like a black hole spiral thing.
Sucked into the middle.
Yeah, you'd become in. Yeah. So
here's the reason.
Just the Christmas trees would kill people.
And this in the article is stated as fact. Of this research, which I don't know how they
can. I have no doubt. I have no doubt that it's factual.
I don't know how they can possibly claim these as facts and not just guesses, but their reasons for more accidental deaths during the holidays is that children are out of school and have access to unsecured guns at their homes, which I don't understand because my children come home from school every day.
Right.
And
that shouldn't change, right?
Nothing changes during the holidays. Adults drink alcohol and don't watch their kids around their guns.
My parents drank alcohol all the time.
I was going to say, my kids come home from school every day and I drink alcohol.
And you're drunk, so.
that's not true.
Okay, new guns are given.
As gifts? I think that's probably the most valid.
Maybe.
If there's
any increase.
And it's a popular time of year for hunting.
Disagree with that entirely.
That it's popular?
That it's a popular time for hunting. No, I mean,
it's a month late in Michigan.
Right. I mean, I don't think that Christmas is the most popular time to hunt.
Right. Right.
So I don't think that's true. So
no, I don't think so. It's absolutely ridiculous. I mean, the article said, well, normally this kind of study would have been done by the CDC, but because of gun laws in 1996,
we can't do it anymore. Right.
Oh, come on. Get over it. Really.
Ridiculous.
So the AP had to do their own study. I think it was a partnership, AP, USA Today, whatever it is, but holy crap. Hey, Donald Trump won.
I heard Donald Trump won an election.
It's kind of old news. But
I don't know what he won. Oh, God, the Electoral College vote, right?
Yeah, so it's
the third time he won.
Third time he's won.
Yeah.
So the third time Hillary Clinton's lost.
So maybe we should assume and accept the fact that Donald Trump is the president-elect, right?
I don't think so, because just today, didn't we finally get all of the states and Washington, D.C. to certify their vote? And Hillary Clinton did, in fact, win the popular vote by like 2.9 million.
That doesn't matter, right?
Oh, but she's more popular.
Yeah, but other presidents have won popular votes and lost electoral. Mm-hmm. Get over it.
That's how it goes. Right? Hey, did you hear about all the so-called faithless electors? You remember it was a big hullabaloo, right, where all of these electors were going to not vote for Trump, and there was a big push to get them all to not vote for Trump.
Heard something about it.
It turns out Hillary Clinton made a record by having the most electors not vote for her who were supposed to in, like, the last 100 years.
Did I hear something about Ron Paul getting some votes?
he got more than Gary Johnson, and he wasn't even running.
Which is odd, right? Is that true?
He got one. Yeah, it's hilarious.
Good for him.
Yeah, well, I think it's more than he got when he was actually running.
That may be true. Yeah. Which tells me that I think you should run for president. And you might get an electoral vote.
Or I should not run and I might get one.
Oh, better yet.
That's what I'm banking on.
Oh, let's see. What else we got going on here?
I don't know. That's about it.
I love Christmas. It's my favorite time of year.
Is it really?
Yeah, it is.
Hmm.
It really is.
The weather?
It's kind of the weather, the cold, the
family?
Yeah, it's family. It's...
I can't think of anything.
The warmth and the wood-burning stoves, and it's just, at least in the, you know, the north part of the country, I don't know what it's like down there for all those bisexual, homosexual people that live in the south, but, you know, I just love Christmas time.
I think we're getting a phone call.
All right.
Thanks for calling Ad Odds. What's on your mind?
Long-time listener, first-time caller, enjoying your show, trying to listen on Red State Radio.
Sure. Okay, well, Red State... Okay, go ahead.
I'm wondering if you could explain a little bit more about how you love Christmas and what your thoughts on religion are.